everybody, and welcome to Limitless Youth Online here at Hereford. We are so excited to have you with us this evening. We don't really know how it's going to go. We have ideas, we have games, we have an incredible talk, and of course, everybody watching, there is going to be pie. I know last week James and Hannah got pied, and if you want to pie James again, by all means, comment away, because that was hilarious to watch. We are so excited to have you with us this evening. And we are sorry we're a bit late, there have been a few technical issues, but we're all up and running now. And so we're gonna kick off the night Limitless with some games, because aren't games incredible fun? I'm gonna hand over now to Sarah, who is gonna lead us in some silly and probably funny and probably really embarrassing games for us as the leaders.
So we're going to start with Chubby Bunny something. So basically we're going to stuff ourselves with marshmallows and see who can fit the most in their mouth.
Okay, are we ready guys?
Doing my lunges, I don't know why.
Okay, ready, steady,
yeah.
Go.
Okay.
So how many are we at? You're not meant to eat them, put them in your mouth. Okay, you on one? Sarah's on two, come on. That's three, you've got to catch up. I mean, it's not the quickest for most, but... Are you chewing that? You can't chew them.
Chubby Bunny.
Four. Still saying Chubby Bunny's great. Steaks, that's incredible.
Chubby Bunny.
You're doing it.
That's five.
Five, where you at? You on five?
Remember, I got 12 last time.
You got 12. Good grief, that's a big mouse.
You were there?
Yeah, I was.
I was on five.
Six, we on six? I mean, how many do you think they're going to get? Six? So, well, they've done six. 10, maybe?
Chubby Bunny.
You can still say chubby bunnies. Can you say chubby bunnies, Sarah? Close, very good. We know James can say it. But James, how many are you at? Seven?
Yeah.
Can you still say chubby bunnies?
Chubby bunnies.
Try again.
Chubby bunnies.
Yeah, I think that's chubby bunnies. They're expanding. Everybody, they're expanding. I think they're getting close to the end. How many are we at, Sarah? Seven? Is it okay, we're at seven for Sarah. James?
Eight.
And they're still going. Stacey, how many have you got?
Four.
Six, incredible. Can you say chubby bunnies? No. You can't do any more. Can you say chubby bunnies, James? Ticking you through it, great. Can you say chubby bunnies, just so we can count this last marshmallow that's gone in your mouth?
Chubby bunnies.
Great, and how many was that? That's just incredible.
10.
Is that just 10? Can you still say chubby bunnies?
Chubby bunnies.
Great. Sarah, what are you at? You're eating them, but she got to eight, so that's a fair play. Well, please either eat them or spit them out and don't choke, but maybe don't do that on camera because that's gross. Well done, friends. Alright, I think we're ready for another game. Our leaders are back and ready.
So we're literally just going to sit on a chair and try to get the ball into the bucket, and then we keep moving the bucket further away or the chair further back, and that's it. See who can throw the ball in the most.
The first round's meant to be easy.
Okay.
Not gonna fail,
you
set me to fail.
Come on.
It's fine.
Okay, that's just showing off. No pressure.
No pressure. Okay. Don't give me
this. Two. Okay. You can
do it. Oh.
So close.
Well, that's quite far already.
Yeah.
Nine.
Oh. But you did lean over there.
Okay.
Excuse me,
you're not referee, Sarah.
Oh, good,
great.
Okay.
You can
do it.
Okay. You didn't get it either, so basically we're drawing.
Go power.
Oh my god!
Only if James can get it in.
And then
okay.
I cannot wait for you to get pie.
Stop it. Well, you will wait because it's not happening.
Can I be the one that pies you?
No. No, that's hard. Just throw it in the bucket. I'm not going to get pie yet.
Ha!
Try again then. Well, yeah, but if I get it in, then you have to get it in. So, we're really bad at throwing. Yeah!
Well, it did go in though.
It came out.
It did go in.
That's true.
That's you've got one more.
I mean, I'm not biased to anything.
If you miss,
I definitely get
a pie. Yeah, you'll definitely get a pie.
Okay. This is what it's all about.
The pressure button, like, that's all of the internet watching.
Tell me off
and
you can
come
forward.
Yeah.
Well, I actually was going to, but then I didn't.
Sorry, Darren.
Sorry, Darren,
this.
Yeah. Sorry.
Hello, Darren.
Yeah!
winner. Okay, we are going to play a game called Guess the Tune.
Can I get part twice? If you
I only knew the new ones.
As quick as Gaston, no one's next as incredibly thick as Gaston, for there's no man in town half as manly. Perfect of your Farragon. You can ask any Tom, Dick, or Stanley. And they'll
is it just called Gaston?
This is really fun.
For you.
Yes. There's a snowman.
Oh, frozen.
Could all of them
play?
I never see you anymore. Come out the door. It's like you've gone away. We used to be best buddies.
Level two.
Oh, what does level two mean? I didn't realize this was gonna get. I think Esther won. Sadly.
So yay! Getting double pie. We'll just give you an even bigger pie.
Right. Can't wait.
Well, hello again. I hope you've been having fun. The games were amazing. So thank you, Sarah, for those. I am very proud of having a big mouth. It just means I can eat more marshmallows. And so tonight we're going to carry on the connection series, looking at those who are often excluded from the club and may not be known well. So this topic is called strangers. So let's play a fun game. I'm going to give you a phrase or a word. What you have to do in the comments is figure out the definition. So for example, I'm going to say lickety split. You've got to guess what the definition is. And the definition of lickety split is to move at great speed. Okay? Leaders, if you know this, please do shout out the definition. So you've got to be listening. That's cheating. That doesn't count, Esther. Okay, cool. Let's get started. So, skedaddle.
To go away really quickly, to get out of there.
To get out of there. So that one, anyone else know what that one is?
To get out there.
To skedaddle means to run away. This one makes me laugh just because it says the word bum in it. Bum fuzzled. What does that mean?
Be confused.
Exactly. Well done. Bumbershoot. What is that? I want the definition for that one.
Shooting someone?
Nope, that's very dark, but yeah, nope. Anyone else? Nope, nope, nope. It is an umbrella, actually. Tara diddle.
See you in a bit.
Nope.
See you later.
Nope.
Tomorrow, bit.
Bye.
Nope.
I'm confused.
No, that was bum fuzzled. Not Tarara diddle. It basically means talking nonsense, rubbish, or lying. Oh. Okay, flibber tigabet.
Fibbing, telling lies.
No, anyone else? It basically means a flaky person or over talkative person. These are very weird definitions. Okay, Bobbergim.
Going to the gym.
No. I can understand why you're saying going to the gym. It basically is the sound that your stomach makes when it rumbles.
After the gym.
Which is basically just, I don't think you can give it a sound. It's just a rumble. Okay. Snickernees. Snickers knee? Dunno.
Having weird looking knees?
weird looking knees. That's a
sneezing.
Good definition. Sneezing. No, it is actually a large knife. So, yeah, very different. A bibliophobia. Come on, we've got to get this one.
Being scared of the Bible?
Being scared of the Bible. Nope, that's not it.
Being scared of bibbles. What's a bibble? I don't know.
A Bible is a bibble.
Being scared of bubbles?
Being scared of bubbles? Nope. Anyone else?
Nope.
I'm going to tell the answer, friends. It's a fear of running out of reading material.
Okay. Who realistically has that? Whoa.
Really?
Yeah.
You read a lot. Okay, next one. Troglodyte.
Chocolate?
Not chocolate. Trog. Troglodyte. Is a person who lives in a cave. I would have just called that person a caveman, to be honest. And vomitory.
Throwing up all the time?
Nope. Sounds like.
Going to vomit?
Nope.
A
lavatory? No, it's not a lavatory. It is an exit in a theatre or amphitheatre. I thought you would have known that, Esther, seeing you're a dramatic person.
Well, now.
Cool. So, now, in the comments, please, can you answer this question for me? How would you define the word stranger? Okay, so I'm going to ask the leaders as well. Esther, can you come up for me, and can you tell me your view of a stranger? What is a stranger?
What, pardon?
How do you define a stranger?
How do I define a stranger? As someone you don't know? Mm-hmm. Someone you don't know is the only thing I've got in my head. Yeah, just someone you don't know, someone you're not comfortable with, maybe. Okay. That's literally the only phrase going around in my head.
Cool. So yeah, a stranger is someone we haven't met before or aren't particularly familiar with. So tonight we're going to be thinking about relationships to strangers and also Jesus's relationship to strangers. So however, I'm not talking about going up to a random person or putting ourselves at danger or putting ourselves at risk, because, you know, stranger danger has always been a thing that you and your parents have been speaking about, so we want to reiterate that one. We're going to be thinking about how we can be more inclusive of those that we don't know very well, or those that are on the edge or on the outlines, or as we in society call misfits. That's what we're going to be talking about tonight. So sometimes in life, there are people who seem a little different to everyone else, who can seem to be other or different, or a person that you kind of probably wouldn't hang out with. And these are people who are often left out, made fun of. So many of these people can feel like strangers, outsiders to everybody else, and we can often view them too. So I'm just going to ask Reva to come up for me. She's going to take a nice seat on one of my comfy chairs. We're going to have a little chat.
Ooh, Reva.
Okay. Get comfy, Reva. They're quite comfortable, these. Okay, so, Reva, the first question is, who in our society might be seen as other or different, and why do you think that?
It's a difficult question. Somebody who is probably doesn't look like you as a person. So I'll see that person as other. Someone who I've never met before. Someone who looks in like different, and whether how they dress, how they look. Someone who is doing a job that is unusual. Oh, I think that list is enough.
Yep, that's a very long list, but hey. Okay, so why do you think some people are excluded or seen this way?
I think the problem is the society, and I think is the culture, because every place have got their own thing that they think is different. For example, when I came to Hereford, I think Hereford is different. The people of Hereford is different. They look different. They speak probably differently from what I'm used to. And I think most of them are farmers, whether that is a perception or is
who in ours
or is true, I don't know. Yes, so I think I've answered that question. I don't even remember what the question is.
I think you did. You said in our society they'd be seen as different. Why do you think people are excluded in the same way? Because obviously they're different. How you see Hereford is completely different to what you're used to. Okay. Now the last question for you is: how might we better include them?
I think the inclusion, I think for me, is a choice. Just because somebody looks different from you doesn't mean they should be treated different. So it's a choice. So inclusion is probably working with your differences, reconcile your differences. And especially we are Christian community, we are supposed to be including everyone because faith doesn't look at color or culture or anything really. It's just Jesus Christ died for all. So as Christians, I think we need to be inclusive, regardless of how somebody looks like, what they do, where they come from, the language they speak. We're supposed just to include them.
Amazing, Reva. Thank you so much. You are free to leave the stage if you feel like it. You can sit here if you want, but I'm only going to be talking. Cool. Amazing. Thank you, Reva. So now we are going to look at strangers in the Bible. There is a woman.
It was a scorching hot day. Jesus was traveling and stopped in Samaria to rest. Under the hot sun, Jesus sat by a well. He was thirsty and hoping someone could help him get a drink. Soon, a woman from Samaria came to the well to draw water. Jesus asked her for a drink. The woman was too shocked to give him water because Jesus was Jewish. And Jewish people did not talk to or hang out with Samaritans. Jesus said,
"It's okay. If you really knew who I am, you would be asking me for water."
"What? You don't even have a bucket. How could you get me water? Hang down into the well by your feet and get water by the handful?"
Jesus could see she was confused.
"Everyone who drinks water from this well will be thirsty again. But I have come to share a living water that will satisfy your thirst forever."
Living water? On a hot day like this, it sounds too good to be true.
"Okay, please give me this living water so I won't be thirsty anymore."
Then Jesus said something she wasn't expecting.
"It's not just water you're looking for. I know that you are lonely and thirsty for friendship."
She had never told anyone about her loneliness. How did this man know this? He seemed like a smart man of God, so she decided to ask him a question that had been on her mind.
"Sir, Samaritans worship on a mountain. Jewish people say we should worship in a temple. Which one is the right answer?"
Jesus answered her,
"That's in the past. Soon, true worshipers will worship the Father in spirit and in truth, anytime, anywhere."
"I know that Christ the Messiah is coming soon. I'm sure he'll explain the rules to us when he gets here."
"Dear woman, I am the Messiah."
The woman could not believe her eyes. The same man who asked her for water, knew everything about her, and told her she could worship anywhere, was the Messiah. She was so excited to tell everyone that she had met Jesus that she'd left her water jar behind at the well. Because of the woman's story, the Samaritans asked Jesus to stay with them. So Jesus stayed for 2 more days, sharing his good news with them.
So, Jesus was part of a group, as the video said, of people called Jews. And the woman in the story was part of a group called what people called Samaritans. And back in those times, Jews and Samaritans, they didn't really seem to get along at all. And so they were trying to have nothing to do with one another. Yet here, Jesus breaks the social norm and starts an interaction with her. He talks to a woman who is considered as the other. He talks to a woman who is considered to be different, a stranger, a person that we don't like or don't associate with. But not just this, but back in those days, it would have been unusual for a man to stop and talk to a woman in the middle of the day like Jesus did. So here he is being inclusive, being engaging with a stranger who would normally be rejected as an outsider because of her womanhood and being a Samaritan. This story is just one of many where Jesus is breaking how society thought he should think and act. There were other things more important to Jesus. Jesus saw people as people, and as the Son of God knows all people are worthy of love and in needs regardless of who they are or what or where they are from. He demonstrates he cares for not just with words but with actions too, and by listening to others. So guys, my challenge to you this week is to talk to a new person that you don't know. Talk to a person that you wouldn't normally kind of like associate with. As Reva said earlier on, that we as Christians in a Christian community are called to be different. We're called to be inclusive. So let's kind of step up and talk to those that we don't speak to. Like Lauren did in last week's challenge video. It was go and do a random act of kindness. Stick a post-it note in someone's door, leave a chocolate bar, all this lot. So I just want to encourage you to this fam, and from me and the team, is that you guys are great, but start being inclusive to those around you.
What an incredible message and such a difficult challenge, but one, guys, that is so worth giving a go. So I have some pretty bad news. Not for you out there, because you'll find it's hilarious. Friends, it is pie time. Oh, yeah! So guys, if I can have you up here on stage with me, both James and Sarah, I will sort out your pies. Come, James, tell us how you're feeling to be pied the second week in a row.
Just got elephants. Whoa, I am echoey. This is great. I'm scared. Please, this was unfair because last time Sarah put like a massive plate load and Hannah got a pied nose. Wait, you gotta do this as well. You gotta do the same amount for Sarah.
Do you want to tell Sarah to speak
about being
pied?
Yeah, Sarah, how do you feel about being pied this week? Your face says it all.
I'm feeling. I've put no words to describe it.
Not great. Well, guys, aren't we hilariously excited? This is one. I mean, if you want to pie each other, but you've got to agree. Like, you can't pie me because I'm MCing and doing the challenge, okay? Because good play, Chili Bunny. Definitely beat you in that game, and I just made this game. I'm so sorry. So, Sarah, this is your pie because it is double pie because it's huge because you lost two games. Bear with, we'll do a countdown. And this is for James. Okay, if you can step up forward, please. Step up forward, move a bit more forward. Ready? Three!
Two!
I mean, it's gonna get messy anyway. What do you want it to go perfectly? Yes. We just wanna see you get pie! So three, two, one! That was so insane! Guys, that was incredible! Well, I hope you can see, and hopefully you don't stick too much of gone-off cream, gross cheese. I do not want you to touch me. I command you in my vicinity. Please go away and clean yourself up. So guys, that's all we have tonight for Limitless here online. You can, if you missed it, that's okay. You can always catch up on our YouTube video. Please do like and subscribe that video, and we can't wait to see you again next week, guys. So have a great week, and tune in next week for some more fun games and absolutely pies.